So you were thinking about getting started with ClickUp, but you wanna understand how to do it. Let me walk you through the 5 steps that you wanna take, including some things you wanna make sure that you do not skip, and I'll show you the most important things to understand as you're first getting started with ClickUp.
I'm Tara Wagner, breakthrough coach and lifelong entrepreneur. I help other entrepreneurs use a holistic approach to business so they can create profits they can depend on without burning themselves out. If that sounds like your jam, be sure to check out my free training on how you can do the same.
So first of all, use my affiliate link in the description. Wink, wink. And what you're gonna do is just pop in your email. That's all you have to do right now. You don't even have to pay to get started. Then you're just gonna go through and fill out the questions that it's asking, picking what you wanna pick. I would just keep it simple for now because all of these things are things that you can go back and edit, and you're gonna want to go back and edit as you get the hang of it. So don't spend a lot of time trying to get things perfect for now. Just use the templates that they give you or the answers or the examples or whatever, and then we'll go in later and make changes to those things. Now, click apps are basically different features that you're gonna use inside of ClickUp. And because you're not gonna necessarily know what you're gonna wanna use yet, go ahead and turn them all on. They're not gonna cause any problems for you if they're turned on, but you're at least gonna know that they're there and remember to use them, versus if you don't turn them on, you're gonna have to try to remember to go back and find them again. So turn everything on to get started. If you'd like to, you can import any tasks that you want to, and then just hit play with ClickUp. It's gonna import everything for you. Then what you can do is set up a template. Now, when it comes to templates, I would not recommend spending hours trying to figure out the perfect one. Scroll through it, grab any that seem interesting to you, but set a time limit on this because you could really fall down the rabbit hole when it comes to templates. What I would recommend you do if you're not sure is just choose a simple one for now. You can always go back through into your template center and choose another template later on down the road, or even move spaces over to a new template if it makes more sense. What I really want you to do here though is ignore all of this for a second. The very first step to take is to actually go into your notifications and edit the crap out of those bad boys. You will have a notification for every little tiny thing inside of ClickUp, which is awesome if you want it. But if you don't want it, you're gonna be completely bombarded with it. So what I actually do is turn off all of my email notifications, but that's because I'm in ClickUp every single day. You may not want to do that to get started. When you're building the habit of checking ClickUp, you may wanna have some of your email notifications turned on. So that it tells you to come in and check it on a regular basis. But if you know you're gonna be in this every single day, go ahead and uncheck all of those so that you can keep your inbox clutter free and keep your work focused inside of ClickUp. I also turn off all of my mobile notifications because I do not like any sort of distractions on my phone. I turn off all of my browser notifications for the same reason, but you get to decide for yourself what makes the most sense for you. I will have any of my starred ones. These are the ones that you cannot turn off. They're required in app, as you can see, to ensure important activity isn't lost. I obviously have all of those turned on, but a lot of different ones I will actually turn off because I don't need a notification for every single tiny thing that my team does. I do keep my reactions on because this allows my team to do a thumbs up on my comments, and that lets me know that they got it. This is a really quick and efficient way for us to communicate without them having to type everything out every time, but I can still get the updates that I need. But I've changed, or I've taken off almost all of my notifications other than the ones that are required. I keep the due date changes on there because I have found for myself that that makes the most sense, but that's on my tasks. You can decide if this is on all tasks that you're following or just your own assigned tasks. ClickBot notifications, we have some ClickBots set up. ClickBot is basically automations. And so I have some automations set up and I want to be notified when those things happen. So I have those notifications on. Comments I mentioned in, obviously we want those notifications on. New comments, reactions, lists assigned to me. Comments I mentioned in, new comments, reactions. Tasks shared, list shared, folder shared, any of those things that are shared with me, I wanna make sure that I get those notifications. But everything else, I turn off so that it is super, super streamlined and I'm not distracted by things that I don't need notifications for. I don't need a notification to let me know that I have a task coming up, that I have a task overdue, that I have a task that I've just created, any of those things. So really go through this with a fine-tooth comb and decide for yourself what makes the most sense. Also, be sure to set up the smart notifications if that makes sense for you. So when you're active on the web, if you don't wanna see notifications right away, maybe you're busy, you're working on something, you don't need it to be coming in constantly, you can change this to be whatever you want it to be. I would also recommend considering whether or not you wanna be a watcher of new subtasks. So if you've created a task and then you have subtasks, I'll show you the hierarchy in just a second. When you have done this, you can be a watcher on anything. And when you're a watcher, you're gonna get notifications for it. So I have this turned off because again, I'm very judicious or very careful about what I'm actually a watcher on and which notifications I'm getting so that I'm not inundated with distractions and I'm able to work on my big rocks throughout the day. So this is the most important thing, your first step, go through, be really picky, and just know you can always go back in and change and update anything that you want to based on what is becoming a distraction or a nuisance and what's actually helpful, what you might be missing. Step number three, you need to memorize the hierarchy before you start playing in it. So I'm gonna explain the hierarchy, break it down for you a little bit. Then I want you to play with it a little bit so that you can really start to understand what it looks like, how it works before you start implementing and putting things into it. So here's the overall hierarchy. Number one, you have your workspace. You can have multiple workspace within one account or within one email. This means, let's say you're a freelancer and you work with a couple different people, they may all have different workspaces that you can be within, or for yourself, maybe you have a business and a personal workspace. These allow you to separate things out so that you can keep things really organized and not overlapping or distracting you when you don't want them to. It can be tricky though, because you will only get notifications for the workspace that you're currently in, so you can miss other things. So keep that in mind when you're setting or playing with those notifications as well. Most of us are only gonna have one workspace. The thing we need to be focusing on is the hierarchy of the spaces. Now I want you to think of spaces kind of like departments inside of your business. How would you break down your business into different departments, different categories, different ways that you wanna organize things, right? You're just chunking things down. So you may have a marketing department, you may have a sales department, you may have a customer success department, you may have an admin department, a tech department, a finance department. All of these can be different spaces. As you can see, I have different spaces. I have one for our SOPs, one for our general team chat. We have our command central station, which is just where a lot of general stuff goes, as well as our company manual. Then I have our Breakthrough Boss Inner Circle. This is everything related to our program in one place. All of our YouTube stuff is in one place. All of our doTERRA stuff is in one place. All of our courses, our other courses, our small ones, are all in one place. Our team folder is all in one place, so we really break everything down according to what makes sense to us. Now, each space or department can then be broken down in two different ways. You can either have a folder system or you can go directly into lists. Folders are just gonna be a way to put similar things in a space all together to keep them chunked together. Lists are gonna be just listed out individually. So you can skip the folder system and go directly to lists, or you can put everything I'm about to say inside of a folder, okay? Is that making sense so far? If it's not, drop me a comment, let me know. But the more you play with this, the more it's gonna make sense. So you have your spaces, potentially folders, and then you have lists either inside of a folder or outside of a folder. Inside those lists, you then have your tasks, and your tasks can then have subtasks. Your tasks can also be separated out inside of a list by status. You can have multiple folders, multiple lists, multiple statuses. Your tasks can have as many subtasks as you need. You can really organize this and break it down really, really well. Once you have the hierarchy memorized, you're starting to understand it, what I want you to then do is set up your first space. Choose a simple department inside of your business, something really easy to organize to set it up for the first time. Don't try to import everything all at once or you're gonna get really overwhelmed. You can always go in later and import everything, but I just want you to do an initial setup of one space to get you started. If you're wanting to break down something like a project, that's generally not gonna be its own space. That's gonna go within a space. So ask yourself, if you have a project, which department of your business does that belong in? This is also where you might wanna spend a little bit more time with the templates and really choosing a template that you're gonna wanna play around with or practice with. You can always change the template later. You can always move things out of a space that you're not liking and into a new space that you've created. You're not locked into anything with ClickUp. So again, just play with it. Inside the Breakthrough Boss Inner Circle, we teach people how to set this up to create kind of their second brain. And one of the things that I teach is to think about the departments in your business, like different hats that you wear. So then we break down the actual lists by the hats in our departments. If you'd like a deeper dive into how I set up my SOPs, how I use my team chat in here, comment below, let me know, and I'll try to make a video on that as well. And then we come to step five. What do you do next to set up your ClickUp? You dive into the deep end. I would recommend you check out these videos. You're gonna learn tons of little tips and tricks, layouts, automations, little things that you can do to start organizing your business. What I recommend that you do is schedule a chunk of time for yourself to get you started, and then a chunk of time every week to learn something new. The learning curve of ClickUp is probably the only bad thing about ClickUp. There's so much that it can do, there's so much potential. So schedule a block of time, 1 to 3 hours a week, where you dive into one new feature and learn one new thing at a time. This playlist will help you get started with that, and if you'd like more support in helping you to streamline and organize your business, be sure to check out my Healthy Hustle Roadmap. You can find the link for that free class in the description below. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful and let me know your biggest takeaway in the comment or fist bump if you've made it to this part of the video. Don't forget to watch these other videos of ClickUp, and thanks for watching this one. I'll see you in the next.